So today we are in a 1,000 horsepower GTR. This is a 2009 for everyone who wants to know. I know you guys have been anticipating this video, and I'm gonna be honest, I'm not nervous. Maybe a little nervous, but before we continue, guys, this is Daniel. Daniel, why don't you introduce yourself?
I'm Daniel. I'm with HG Motorsports. Manage all the GTR builds and a lot of the American stuff as well. So this car is a really good example of a higher horsepower car that you can actually drive on the street.
It's not as scary.
Right.
I mean, like, it's scary right. When you look at it, yeah. But when you, like, kind of get behind it,
yeah.
You kind of... the more you drive it, the less it gets more intimidating. I mean,
yeah.
Obviously,
yeah.
They know that I drove it a little bit beforehand,
right.
But I mean,
yeah.
As you're getting into it, it's not the scariest thing in the world.
Yeah, so the thing with this car is it's a lot of power, but it's built in a way that it's actually usable power on the street. It's really, really nice to be able to, like, have a turbo that actually spools up relatively fast and still hit really, really hard.
So, speaking of, like, turbo spooling up, what's all done to this car exactly as far as, like, engine performance-wise?
Yeah, so this car has, engine-wise, it's a Cosworth engine. It's a built motor, forged internals, all that stuff. And then a Shepherd transmission stage 2 to handle the power that this thing puts out. It's a Schweitzer P800. Turbo system, and then we upgraded the injectors, fuel pumps, even more to 1300s and the DW300Cs, and then it's also running on Ecutec, and then Delicious Tuning Flex Fuel Kit. So it's a lot of different stuff done. That's kind of the gist of it. On E85, the car made 913 at the wheel and 800 torque at, I think it was like 4500 RPM. So that's a really low torque number at that power level for a car like this. Most cars with this much power will not make that much torque this low, and that's what makes this thing a really fun street car.
That's quite a build list. Damn,
yeah.
I didn't think I realized it was that much.
There's more stuff too. I could go on. It's just I figured. With 91 right now, we're running at 91. It's probably about 650-ish at the wheels.
Uh-huh.
Maybe the similar torque. Once you put E85 in it, it literally transforms the car. It feels like a completely different car. But even on 91, it's still
yeah. Even on 91, it's still gonna be
still pretty quick.
Yeah. So that right there was like maybe quarter throttle.
Yeah.
And that's crazy.
Yeah. It's hard to describe the power, and especially watching someone, like, you really have to experience it. And I've taken people with really, really fast cars,
uh-huh.
who they consider fast,
well,
for a ride in this,
remember,
and they're like, this is the fastest car I've ever been in.
Remember that GT3?
Yeah,
and that,
exactly.
Like,
right.
It's just gone.
Yeah.
Absolutely gone.
Yeah.
And it's like, we're on the freeway right now, if you guys can't tell, and it's casual.
We can talk.
Yeah, I can talk. I mean,
yeah.
In my car, I can't even speak on the freeway.
Right.
And although, like, I feel like, you hear like 1,000 horsepower, all these crazy numbers. I feel like you think it's impractical as far as like getting on the road, and
right.
I mean, it's
really not.
It's fine.
Yeah.
But when you drop a gear and you put your foot down, like,
yeah.
You are not ready, and you don't know how much space you actually have in front.
Yeah.
What's in front of you comes way faster. I think you really realize.
Absolutely.
And that's what you were telling me. You're
yeah.
Like, just understand
yeah.
How quick that space just disappears.
Right. Well, you feel the torque, which is a really impressive number. You can't see horsepower. You see horsepower in a number, in a mile an hour, or how fast you're moving over time. So,
right.
When you step on it and there's a car a mile ahead of you, you'll catch up to it real fast.
Second gear, 3,000. Oh my God. That feels a passenger.
Yeah, pretty gnarly.
That for me was like, holy shit.
Yeah.
Wow, that E85 made a huge difference.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying, the torque when it comes on. But it's nice because it's still really linear. It's not like you have to wait for it. It comes on basically right away.
All right, we're at fourth. We're going to drop to third. We're at 4,500. Going about 60. That was like over. Holy shit, Daniel. You don't even understand how fast you're going
right.
Before you get there.
Right.
I mean, even in me, like, First of all, it's like light speed.
Right.
And in the middle of my chest, it's like, it. There's a feeling I've never felt before. There's like this.
Is that torque?
Wow.
Yeah.
And even as the driver, nothing typically feels this fast because you're expecting it, like you're anticipating it.
Right. Just do a quick fourth gear and see how fast you get up to that car.
Okay. So about fourth gear, 3,500. Let's to the floor. I want to take a note on those brakes.
They're track pads.
It's crazy. Normally I go to like back roads to do these reviews, but notice that the road we're on right now, open freeways, like you can't, I won't say you can't, but I would not take this car on a back road because it's just, no.
You can't do it. I've taken the car through back roads and you literally cannot get on the power.
Yeah.
I basically go to map one, which is like low power, so like, you know, 800 horsepower, whatever, but you basically can't get on it. It's just too much. It doesn't like to turn and accelerate.
Yeah.
You know, the car's been on track. It's not really built as a track car. It's built as a really fun street car to show people like what you can do with a car like this and how 1,000 horsepower, again, can be drivable and usable.
It's like, as I'm driving it, I'm still like trying to comprehend
how
fast it is. Yeah. And I remember being a passenger in it. I know you said you haven't been a passenger in a while, and it's blurring.
Yeah,
and as a driver, I mean, I'm very just tunnel vision focused on what's in front of me, because that's the biggest thing. It's when you floor it, you're not worried about like the turns or whatever. You're worried about make sure that you know how like fast that gap in front of you is gonna close.
Exactly. And even guys with modified GTRs, they're not to this level, but modified GTRs get in this car and they're like, it's on a different level. It really is.
It's gnarly.
That's not to say, like, a stock turbo E85 GTR is really, really fast. It'll beat, you know, 95% of cars on the street.
Yeah.
But once you get to this, especially on the freeway, there's a different level. And we're talking another almost 300 wheel horsepower over a stock turbo E85 car.
This is second gear. Little bit squirrely, but
second gear's fun. I like that gear.
Holy shit! Oh my god, second gear. It's like the nope gear.
Right.
We were talking about going first gear if I even wanted to attempt it, and I don't. I know a lot of you guys be like, oh, why don't you go first gear? It's, I'm not gonna say it's useless in this car, but like,
it's almost useless.
It's almost useless. It's just, there's nothing, you can't hook up. Do I dare? Second gear. I was gonna say, I'm gonna keep going straight.
Second gear is gnarly.
Yeah, second gear. I may almost say second gear maybe the favorite gear.
Yeah.
See, it's like, I coming up to a turn, I go on the throttle a little bit, and it's like, it's coming way too fast.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
I don't know how to explain that, but it's like, you can't do turns with this.
Right.
Because the throttles, it's just too much.
Yeah.
Not that that's a bad thing, but this is how this is built.
Right, and then it's also got really, really wide tires, and a lot of people think wider tire handles better. It's not necessarily true. Because
can't you, like, overdo it?
Right, it's a little bit too much tire to really... I mean, the car's been on the track, it still handles really well, but it's a lot of tire to kind of move around with agility.
Right.
You know?
This is a third gear. That right there, that was like 40, like that. It's weird to think about in my head, to think about how fast that just came.
Going uphill.
And then that was uphill too.
Yeah.
What? It's like, okay, an example of this car, and I think this, a lot of people will be able to resonate with this example. Let's say you're playing Forza Horizon 2 on Xbox, and you buy your GTR, and you just basically just choose the option to upgrade it as fast as possible. You just do the full upgrade, you spend like 80,000 credits on upgrading the GTR. That's what this is. That's like the GTR that will just, you go to the airstrip in Forza and then you just start doing pulls. That's this car. That's what this is. It amuses me how like you're still feeling like, oh my god, and you drive it all the time.
Right.
Being a passenger, it's just another game.
Yeah.
That's first gear. here. See, we can feel the tail go a little bit. That was first, barely any throttle. Right. Yeah, third gear here. What? I don't even want to say the number on that, but guys, that was... could have been the fastest I've ever... I don't even know. It's hard to glance down exactly. when all you can do to not die is... like, you can't look anywhere but straight. Even just to glance down really quick, it's like, no. That's the move that you don't want
to
do.
I always feel like that, too. I'm always, like, afraid to look down.
Yeah, it's like, how fast am I going? Because I can't look. Alright guys, I want to thank you so much for watching this review. Huge thanks to HG for letting me just rip this around. Daniel, the man, guys, Instagram's here. If you have any questions about this car, if you have any questions about HG or anything build related, they're the ones who built the BRZ, supercharged it. Shout out to Alan for doing that. Again, Daniel, thank you for not pooping your pants during the review.
Yeah, I did one.
Thank you all so much for watching. Peace out and keep moving forward.
Motivation is contagious. Hang out with those who inspire you and strive not to be like them, but only a better version of yourself. You will learn that there is a difference between alone and lonely. Life isn't always easy, but that's the beauty. You will learn how to be truly happy, and as much as you don't want to...
Oh, shit!
It's insane, dude!